We will now study about the various defects or the disorders that are related to vision and how those defects can be corrected. So let us quickly go through the various problems that are related to vision. Firstly, problems due to loss of power of accommodation. So we have studied what is power of accommodation, that is how the focal length is changed by the lens by changing its size. That is, when we are viewing distant object, it becomes thin, and when we are viewing nearby objects, it bulges out or the curvature increases, and thereby the change in the focal length is brought about when we are seeing distant object and nearby object. You can try this, and the adjustment or the power of accommodation of the eyes is very strong. And you can try this by seeing a distant object and a nearby object very quickly. So just try to see an object which is away from you, and immediately then try to see the object that is close to you. So this adjustment of the focal length is brought about by the eye lens very quickly. And this is what we refer it to as the power of accommodation. But as the age of the person advances, this power of accommodation gradually starts becoming lesser or weak, and this introduces certain defects. So we will study what these defects are. Secondly, weakening of the ciliary muscles. Now, ciliary muscles, we have seen that the lens is held in its position with the help of ciliary muscles, and they even play a very important role in bringing about the change in the curvature of the lens. So if these ciliary muscles become weak as the age of the person advances, and due to this the power of accommodation becomes weak, and it introduces certain defects. So weakening of the ciliary muscles introduces defects and loss of power of accommodation also. Then change in the size of the eyeball. Now we have seen that the size of the eyeball, that is the diameter, is about 2.4 centimeters. And vitreous humor, aqueous humor, we have seen that those watery fluids which are present inside the eyes, they play a very important role in maintaining the shape of the eyeball. So any change in the size of the eyeball will introduce defects. Sometimes the eyeball becomes elongated, and sometimes it becomes flattened and does not remain spherical, which it should actually be. And that also introduces disorders. Irregularities on the surface of the cornea. Now, cornea, which is the outermost part of the eyeball, transparent membrane, very thin and responsible for maximum refraction of light. And this cornea has got a perfect spherical shape. There are no irregularities. But if there are irregularities, if the curvature is not smooth, in that case, it introduces disorders. Lastly, formation of membrane over the lens, which is commonly called as cataract. So this is a very common disorder which is found in people after the age of 50, 55, 60 years. And in this particular disorder, we find that the eye lens becomes hazy, or it becomes very dense or cloudy. So in cataract, the lens becomes very dense and cloudy. And the cataract begins when the proteins in the eye form clumps, and that prevents the lens from sending a clear image to the retina. We know that the light enters through the cornea and then passes through the other various parts inside the eye, and finally it reaches the lens, where it converges the rays of light and the image is formed on the retina. But due to cataract and the development of the proteins which become form clumps, and that makes the lens very hazy and cloudy, and due to this the rays of light are not able to reach the retina. And retina also, we know that it's a light sensitive screen. If light doesn't refract properly over it, you will not be able to see the objects. So the function of the retina is to convert the light that is coming in through the lens into signals, that is electrical signals, and then it sends to the brain via the optic nerve. So the lens, if it becomes hazy, then it results in a disorder which is called as cataract. But we know that cataract is treatable and the normal vision can be restored. So these are some of the defects and defects of the vision, and we have to study what corrections can be done in these cases. Coming to the first defect, it is called as myopia or nearsightedness. The name itself is telling, near sight means the person will be able to see only nearby objects clearly, but the distant objects will not be seen clearly or distinctly. So the eye can see nearby objects clearly, but the distant objects appear indistinct. So it's not that the person is unable to see the distant objects, but they will appear to be indistinct or unclear. So let us first try to understand this diagram here. This is nearby objects can be seen clearly by the myopic eye. So here the rays are coming from a nearby object, and required changes in the focal length are brought about by the eye lens. That is, the eye lens will decrease the focal length, and the image will be formed on the retina. So this is for nearby objects, because nearby objects can be seen clearly. Now coming to the myopic eye, that is the defect. The person is not able to see the distant objects clearly. So the rays of light coming from a distant object are parallel. So you have to show parallel rays of light. And now you can see that after falling onto the eye lens, they are all converging here. That is, they are converging in front of the retina. Now this is happening due to the increase in the converging power of the eye lens. The converging power of the eye lens has increased, and as a result, the rays, they converge before they reach the retina. That is, they converge at a point in front of the retina. So the image that will be formed on the retina will not be clear, and the person will not able to see the distant objects clearly. Now let us first try to understand the reasons, all reasons that are responsible for myopia. So the first reason, high converging power of the lens, that we have just now seen, that due to the high converging power, the rays converge before they reach the retina. Second reason, curvature of the lens and cornea increases. Now you must remember here that whenever you are seeing distant objects, the lens becomes very thin and the focal length is maximum. So exactly reverse happens here. You find that the curvature of the lens and cornea increase. So the curvature increases means the lens bulges out. So instead of becoming thin, it bulges out, or the curvature increases. Even cornea, the curvature increases. Muscles near the lens do not relax sufficiently. So ciliary muscles we had talked about, and due to the advancement in age, the ciliary muscles become weak, and therefore they do not relax sufficiently so as to increase the focal length, and hence focal length decreases. So as a result of all these things, the focal length remains small and the person is not able to see the distant objects clearly. Eyeball is elongated, and hence distance between lens and retina increases. So here you have the picture of an elongated eyeball. Now this is the length of the normal eye. That is, this is the dotted line which they have shown here. This is the normal shape of the eyeball. But now due to the elongation of the eyeball, the retina has shifted here. So the distance between lens and retina has increased. So eyeball is elongated, and hence distance between lens and retina increases. So due to the change in the shape of the eyeball, this disorder is introduced. Now coming to the correction. Now we have seen that the converging power is very high of the lens. So if the converging power is very high, we need to slightly diverge the rays of light. And if we want to diverge the rays of light, we must make use of a concave lens, which is a diverging lens. So we make use of a concave lens. Now rays that are coming from a distant object here, you can see that they fall onto the concave lens. After falling, they slightly diverge. So when you are drawing the diagram, you must remember this: slight divergence needs to be shown here, but the ray shouldn't move out of the lens here. They must touch the lens. And then required convergence is brought about by the eye lens. And now you find that the rays meet on the retina. That is, the focal length is now whatever is required to see the distant object is achieved, and the person can see the distant objects clearly. So concave lens is used to correct the disorder. Power of spectacles is negative for myopic eye. Now we are making use of a concave lens. So concave lens, the focal length is negative. We take F1 into account, which is on the left side of the optical center. And so the focal length for concave lens is negative. And the power of lens is given by P is equal to 1 upon F, that is reciprocal of focal length. So power of lens will be also negative because focal length is negative. Since focal length is negative, power of the lens will also be negative. So power of spectacles is negative for myopic eye. So I hope you have understood this first disorder, that is myopia or nearsightedness.